Hello everyone, this is Deepthi and this is my first video on flickering light bulbs. So I just tried my hand a little on mandala and that's how I ended up creating this video. I'm not a mandala artist, so this will just be an introductory video. So let's get started. Mandala or mandal in Sanskrit refers to circle, and the patterns made in the mandala act as a source to healing. In many Asian cultures, mandala designs are used as a symbol for signifying sacred places for meditation and prayer. And some believe them to be symbols of good luck and fortune. Many Asian temples have incorporated intricate mandalas in the form of wall and ceiling paintings. Although Buddhist culture has predominantly incorporated mandala as a means to spirituality, there are huge traces of other forms of mandala in Hinduism and Shintoism too. Let's discuss a few influences here. In Hinduism, sacred spaces are adorned with a kind of mandala known as yantra. But unlike the mandalas we draw regularly, yantras are not self-reflective. These are fixed in design and are meant for drawing cosmic harmony to rituals and living spaces. Mandalas have also been used to demonstrate the economic and political stature of a state. The term Rajmandala was introduced by Kautilya in Arthashastra. The basic idea in Rajmandala was explained by Kautilya that the immediate neighbor of a state is the enemy, whereas the one next to the neighbor could be a friend, and so on and so forth. So if the state is a Vijigishu or the conqueror, then the neighbor is an Ari or enemy, and the one next to it is Mitra. And so on. The lotus element in the work of most of the modern day mandala artists has its root in Japanese Taima mandala that was manifested in the Pure Land Buddhism adopted in the Mahayana Buddhism. The lotus represents enlightenment and is believed to purify thoughts. Flower mandalas often reference a lotus and are embodiment of beauty, passion, love, growth, and hope. Creating mandalas is a healing process, but more than that, it requires a lot of discipline. So before proceeding into the process, here are some tips. Geometry needs to be respected. Uniformity is the crux of getting the mandala done correctly. Some say the precision required is similar to getting calligraphy done, and that is why guidelines or trace lines are a must for beginners. Be it a circular mandala or any other shape. If you plan to create a pattern, ensure that every shape in the pattern is uniform. Thickness of lines. A mandala with regular thickness in patterns looks messy, and hence pens of specific thickness are preferred. The pens for mandalas are easily available online from many companies, and you can also purchase them from local stores. Focus and patience. Getting each shape to look correct and flawless requires a lot of patience. Forms that look easy to create also require a lot of time investment. Although some say that this may not be the prerequisite because you eventually learn it in the process. Tools for creating a mandala. A mandala can be monochromatic, which means a single color can be used to draw, sketch, and shade the entire mandala. Or it can be multicolored, wherein you can use more than two colors and make it as colorful as possible, or entirely black line work. You will need the tools, pencils, colors, which can be watercolors, crayons, or colored ink, 200 to 300 GSM paper, and measuring tools like scales, compass, and stencils. And last but not the least, if you like our video, like, share, and subscribe on YouTube. And you can also follow me on Instagram at artverse_flb or flickering_lightbulbs.